Hello all. Now today we will be starting with the topic that is epilepsy. Okay. Now what do we mean by the word epilepsy? Epilepsy means recurrent seizures. Epilepsy means recurrent seizures. Now what do we mean by the word seizure? Seizure means any abnormal neuronal discharge. So there is some neuron in our brain which discharges abnormally, that is seizures. So remember, one episode of seizure doesn't require treatment. What requires treatment is epilepsy or recurrent seizures. Okay, if the seizures are occurring again and again, then it requires treatment. Okay, now the point is, there is a similar term known as convulsions. Convulsions means the movement in the body which occurs due to seizures. This is the movements due to seizures. So if there is some motor neuron firing in our brain, it causes movement. Okay, but remember, all seizures do not have convulsions. Exception is absence seizure. There are certain seizures in which there is no convulsions in the body. Okay, that is absence seizures. So some certain seizures, they are associated with body movement. Body movement due to seizure is known as convulsions. Now in this section of epilepsy, we will be discussing about what is the various treatment of epilepsy, treatment of different epilepsy, and the second part we will be discussing about the properties of anti-epileptic drugs. We will be discussing about anti-epileptic drugs, what are their indications, side effect, etc. So let's first discuss about the treatment of epilepsy. Now the point is, what is the treatment of epilepsy? Remember, if a patient comes to you with acute attack of seizure, if a patient comes to you with acute attack of seizure, we will manage this thing. We will manage the acute attack. And second point, we will give certain drug which will prevent recurrence, which will prevent recurrence of seizures. Okay, that will prevent recurrence of seizure. Now, how to manage an acute attack of seizure? Remember, we generally do not suppress the acute attack of seizure. We only give drugs when this seizure attack lasts for more than 5 minutes. If the seizure is not stopping after 5 minutes, then we start a drug. Okay? And the seizure which is not controlled after, which is not stopping after 5 minutes, is also known as status epilepticus. So what is the status definition of status epilepticus? Status epilepticus means the acute attack of seizure which requires some drug treatment, and they generally last for more than 5 minutes. Okay, so the definition of status epilepticus has been changed. So status epilepticus is acute attack of seizure. It is an acute attack of seizure that require drug treatment. Okay, now what is the drug of choice if a patient is having seizure for more than 5 minutes? For status epilepticus, remember, the drug of choice is benzodiazepines. Why? They are the fastest acting anti-epileptic drugs we have. Okay, benzodiazepine. So we give which drug? We will write, among them, benzodiazepine, the drug of choice is intravenous lorazepam. Okay, it is the drug of choice for status epilepticus. If lorazepam is not available, you can give other drugs like intravenous midazolam, we can give clonazepam, and we can give diazepam. But lorazepam is considered as a drug of choice. Okay, now if this attack is not controlled by lorazepam, then we add other anti-epileptic drugs. Then we add other drugs like valproate. We will write fosphenytoin. We will give levetiracetam. Okay, levetiracetam, So these drugs we generally add on. But what is expected from you is drug of choice. Drug of choice is lorazepam. If it is still not controlled, then we add phenobarbital. If still it is not controlled, then we put the patient on general anesthesia. Of various drugs like thiopentone, propofol, etc. Okay. So what is expected from you is, what is the drug of choice for acute seizure attack or status epilepticus, that is benzodiazepine and lorazepam. Okay. So this is how we manage. Now the point is to prevent further attack of seizures, because in epilepsy there is recurrent seizures, we give various anti-epileptic drugs. Okay. Now it will depend upon the type of epilepsy. We will choose the anti-epileptic drug on the basis of type of epilepsy. Okay. So let's see what are the various types of epilepsy we know, and what are the drug of choice or the first line drug we prefer to give in various types of epilepsy. So let's make a heading: types of seizures or types of epilepsy. Okay. So let's divide epilepsy into three types. The first is generalized seizures or generalized epilepsy. Okay. So generalized seizures or generalized epilepsy. It means, suppose this is the brain, these are the two lobes of the brain. In generalized epilepsy, sir, both lobes of the brain are, the neurons which are present in both lobes of the brain, they are firing. Okay. The second we have is focal epilepsy or focal seizures. In focal seizures, only one group of neuron in one lobe of the brain are firing. Okay. So in focal, only a group of neurons are firing. In generalized, all are firing. Apart from this, we have certain other miscellaneous causes of epilepsy, and here we will discuss various epilepsy syndrome. So first we will focus upon this generalized seizure and focal seizure. After that we will come to epilepsy syndromes. Now what about generalized seizure? So these generalized seizures, they are further divided into the type of convulsions the patient will present, the type of body movement the patient will have. On this basis we will divide generalized seizures into different type, the type of body movement. Okay. The first is, the most common form is GTCS. GTCS stands for generalized tonic clonic seizures. Okay. So in this patient, in this case, the patient will have suddenly increase in tone of the body, then clonic movement, to and fro clonic movement, then the patient will become unconscious. Okay. And after that, so the patient will wake up and the patient will have memory loss. Now this epilepsy is the most common form of epilepsy, and it is also known as grand mal epilepsy. It is also known as major epilepsy. Okay. These are the two other names of GTCS. Okay. Now, what is the drug of choice or the first line drug for GTCS? We will write, the most preferred drug for GTCS are valproate and lamotrigine. Okay. So they are the first line drug. We will choose according to the patient compliance and the side effect and tolerability. So the drug of choice or the first line drug for GTCS is either valproate or lamotrigine. They both are equally effective, and there are many other drugs which are add-on drugs. Okay. Now the second one we have is absence seizures. Now, why they are known as absence seizures? Because the patient will have no convulsions. So there will be no body movement. So if there is no body movement, then how we will come to know that the patient is having absence seizure? We can diagnose absence seizure on the basis of EEG, electroencephalogram only. And in electroencephalogram, absence seizure shows typical 3 hertz wave spike pattern. Okay, they show typical 3 hertz wave spike pattern. Now the point is, these absence seizure, they are also known as petit mal epilepsy. They are also known as minor epilepsy. Now, what is the drug of choice for absence seizure? We will continue to write valproate and lamotrigine, but we will write ethosuximide. So there are 3 first line drug out here: ethosuximide, valproate, and lamotrigine. Okay. Now the point is, this ethosuximide is not available in India. In India, it is not available. Okay. Now, the third type of epilepsy we have is, we will write the rest, all other generalized epilepsy. You will write, if the patient is only having myoclonic, to and fro motion of the body, myoclonic epilepsy, tonic epilepsy, the tone of the body will increase, atonic epilepsy, suddenly the muscle tone will decrease and the patient will fall down, or we can write some atypical absences are. Atypical absence seizure means the patient is not having this typical 3 hertz wave spike pattern. Now in this case, in all these other cases, remember, in this ethosuximide is not effective. Okay, ethosuximide is the specific drug for absence seizure. Here again we will write valproate and lamotrigine. And the third drug we will add is topiramate. So here there are 3 first line drug, topiramate. Okay, so this is the all type of generalized seizure. So can we say that in all generalized seizure, valproate and lamotrigine are effective in all type of generalized seizure? Ethosuximide is only effective in absence seizure. What about topiramate? Topiramate is the first line drug for myoclonic, tonic and atonic seizure or absence seizure. Topiramate can be given as a second line add-on drug in cases of GTCS. It is effective in GTCS. It can be added. Okay, but absence seizure is the only drug. It is only effective in absence seizure, no other seizures. Now let's talk about focal seizures. Okay, now in focal seizure, what happens, in the patient brain the neurons are firing only in a group of neurons are firing. Okay, both lobes are not firing, only a group of neurons are firing. This is focal seizure. So focal seizures can be associated with discognitive symptoms. Okay, discognitive symptoms. So cognitive level will decrease in some cases. In some people, there is no discognitive symptom. There is no discognitive decline. The cognitive level of the patient will not decline. Okay, so they are further divided, but it is irrelevant for us because the treatment of all focal seizures is same. So what are the first line drug we have in focal seizures? The first line drug in focal seizures, we can write a mnemonic, that is Lokpal. Okay, again we will write lamotrigine. So lamotrigine is a drug which is given in all type of seizures. Okay, then we have carbazepine, we have carbamazepine, then we have phenytoin, and lastly we have levetiracetam. Okay, So these are the first line drugs for focal seizures. We will choose the base drug on the basis of response on a patient as well as the side effect of a drug, if a patient can tolerate a drug or not. So these are the first line drug for focal seizures. Now let's talk about the other miscellaneous causes of seizures. Or we can write epilepsy syndromes, various epilepsy syndromes. Okay, so let's write about the first epilepsy, that is juvenile myoclonic epilepsy. So why it is known as juvenile myoclonic epilepsy? Because it is seen in teenage group, and in teenage group it is the most common cause of epilepsy. Now the point is, you are seeing here myoclonic word is coming. Myoclonic, if you see back, we have written here myoclonic epilepsy. So can we say there are three drugs which are effective in myoclonic epilepsy? So in juvenile myoclonic epilepsy also, valproate, lamotrigine and topiramate are effective drug. Now the point is, among these three drugs, valproate is considered as a drug of choice. The drug of choice for juvenile myoclonic epilepsy is valproate, because it is the most effective drug in myoclonic epilepsy we have. Okay, it is the most effective drug in myoclonic epilepsy we have. There is one more drug we will write here, is levetiracetam. Okay, levetiracetam has been recently approved, and it is the most preferred drug in pregnancy, because I will tell you, valproate will be the most teratogenic drug in pregnancy. So in pregnancy, we prefer to give levetiracetam. If both options are given, juvenile myoclonic epilepsy in pregnancy, then your answer will be levetiracetam. If levetiracetam is not given, you can give valproate in pregnancy also. Although it is teratogenic, still we can give. Okay? Because we have to control seizures mainly. Okay? Now, just remember two points. In any myoclonic epilepsy, there are two drugs which are absolutely contraindicated. That is phenytoin, and the brother of phenytoin, carbamazepine. Remember, these two drugs are absolutely contraindicated in any type of myoclonic epilepsy. Okay? So remember, phenytoin and carbamazepine are absolutely contraindicated in myoclonic epilepsy. Okay? Now let's talk about one more cause of myoclonic epilepsy. That syndrome is known as Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. Okay? Lennox-Gastaut syndrome, it is a very rare cause of epilepsy. Here the patient has, it is seen in the children 2 to 6 years of age, and it is associated with mental retardation. The patient has mental retardation also. Now which type of epilepsy a patient presents us? The patient presents with myoclonic, atonic and atypical absence seizure. And we have already written for myoclonic, atonic and atypical absence. If we see here again, we had written valproate, lamotrigine and topiramate. Okay, so if we have the drugs which are effective against Lennox-Gastaut syndrome is valproate, lamotrigine and topiramate. And in Lennox-Gastaut syndrome, the drug of choice is valproate. It is given with a combination of a drug, clobazam. Clobazam is a type of benzodiazepine. So we give a combination of valproate and clobazam. This combination is the best drug. And among, if one question will come, the drug of choice is again valproate. It is the most effective drug. Now the point is, if it is not controlled by this valproate, then we have developed two specific drug for Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. The drug is rufinamide. And in resistant cases, we add a drug, felbamate. These two drugs we have specifically made for Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. Okay. While valproate, lamotrigine, and topiramate, they are broad. They have broad indication. These two drugs, they are specifically we have made for Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. Okay. So remember this part. What is the treatment of Lennox-Gastaut syndrome? Okay. Now let's talk about one more myoclonic epilepsy. That's another myoclonic epilepsy is Dravet syndrome. What is Dravet syndrome? Dravet syndrome is also known as severe myoclonic epilepsy of infancy. In this case, again, the child will have myoclonic seizure and the age group of that child is less than 1 year. Okay. So there will be various spasm and myoclonic epilepsy in the children. Again, we know there are three drugs which are approved for myoclonic epilepsy. That is valproate, lamotrigine, and topiramate. Okay. Now, we have made a drug which is specifically for Dravet syndrome. That is a barbiturate stiripentol. We have specifically made for Dravet syndrome. Okay. And we can also add clonazepam. Okay. So remember the word stiripentol. We prefer to give stiripentol because it is the safest drug we have. Valproate, lamotrigine, etc. They are very unsafe drug in children less than in infants actually. But traditionally, the drug of choice for Dravet syndrome is again valproate. But stiripentol we have made for Dravet syndrome. Okay. We have made stiripentol for Dravet syndrome. Now, let's move further. One more epilepsy in infant known as infantile spasm. It is also known as West syndrome. Okay. What is the pathogenesis? Why it occurs? It occurs in small children less than 1 year of age and the muscle goes into spasm. The reason is there is increase in level of corticotropin releasing hormone in the brain, CRH, corticotropin releasing hormone. So what is the treatment? The treatment of infantile spasm is, the drug of choice is ACTH hormone with glucocorticoids. So we give hormones. We give these hormones for infantile spasm. Okay. Why ACTH, adrenocorticotropin releasing hormone, and glucocorticoid? Because this ACTH and glucocorticoid will give a negative feedback, and because of this negative feedback, they will decrease the level of CRH hormone. Okay. Now the point is, if there is resistance to these drugs, or if there is recurrence again, or if this infantile spasm is associated with a genetic condition, in this genetic condition, these ACTH hormone and glucocorticoid are not effective. Okay. This genetic condition is tuberous sclerosis. It's an autosomal dominant condition in which the child has various congenital abnormalities. Okay. The child has angiomyolipomas, adenoma cecum, mental retardation. So in this case, if this infantile spasm is associated with tuberous sclerosis, This is very resistant to ACTH and glucocorticoid, and it is alone cannot be controlled. The drug of choice for infantile spasm, which is associated with tuberous sclerosis, is vigabatrin. The drug of choice is vigabatrin. It's a very important question, you have to remember. Okay, so the drug of choice is vigabatrin in cases of infantile spasm which are associated with tuberous sclerosis. Okay, now we have made certain new other drugs which are we are trying in infantile spasm. We are making a drug ganoxolone. Okay, so this is a new drug which is tried in infantile spasm. But remember, the drug of choice is vigabatrin. It's a very important point, you must remember. Okay, ganoxolone. Now let's talk about the next scissor, that is febrile scissors. Okay, febrile scissors. So febrile scissors, they occur when in a small children when there is fever. Due to very high grade fever, these children, they suffer from acute attack of seizures. If there is acute attack of seizure, the drug of choice is intravenous diazepam. Okay, if intravenous route cannot be accessed, then we can also give rectal diazepam. Okay, rectal diazepam, remember this point. Now what is the other option? We can give intranasal midazolam, but this diazepam is considered as a drug of choice. We can give midazolam as well, but diazepam is considered as a drug of choice. Okay, diazepam intravenous is preferred, it can be. Okay, now the point is, if the patient is having again and again intermittent or recurrent attacks of febrile seizure, then the drug of choice is rectal diazepam. Okay, rectal diazepam. We can give valproate as well. We can give valproate as well. Okay, and we have to decrease fever also. So we give tepid sponges. We give paracetamol to prevent fever with ibuprofen. Okay, with ibuprofen, these are NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. But what is expected from you is this diazepam. Okay, now let's move forward. Let's talk about a scissor known as mesial temporal lobe epilepsy. Okay, so in this case, the patient can have any type of seizure, focal or generalized seizure. The point is, mesial temporal lobe epilepsy is generally a very refractory cause of epilepsy. It is refractory to drugs. But in this epilepsy, there is a role of surgery. There is a role of surgery. We remove that part which is near the temporal lobe. So we will remove the part of the brain. We will remove temporal lobe. Or if the neurons have died in other areas, we can remove amygdala. We can remove hippocampus where the neurons are firing abnormally. So there is a role of surgery. We remove these areas depending upon the focus of scissor. Okay, focus of scissor. Let's move forward. Now the last epilepsy we will second last we will write is Rolandic epilepsy. Rolandic epilepsy, the drug of choice is carbamazepine. Okay, the drug of choice for Rolandic epilepsy is carbamazepine. Now eighth, the last one is catamenial epilepsy. Okay, catamenial epilepsy. Catamenial epilepsy means the epilepsy which is associated with menstrual cycles. Okay, menstrual cycles. So what is the management of catamenial epilepsy? In catamenial epilepsy, we generally increase the dose of anti-epileptic drugs. Because menstrual cycle, due to alteration of plasma protein, there is fluctuation in the dose level of anti-epileptic drug. Add progesterones like progestins, like medroxyprogesterone acetate. Okay. There is a role of, although nowadays we don't much use, there is a role of a drug acetazolamide. So earlier acetazolamide was very preferred drug, but now we manage by giving, increasing the dose of the same anti-epileptic drug and in by adding progesterones. Okay. And by adding progesterones. Now this is all about the management and the drug of choice for various epilepsies. Now let's make a heading, anti-epileptic drugs. So let's make a heading now.